The guys in this gym pump some serious iron. They can easily bench press 300 pounds or more. But what if I told you that they won't be able to lift this 110-pound woman? And it's all because of science.
To do that, she's gonna have to put on some serious weight. So how do you triple your weight in 2 seconds?
All right.
What's up?
I bet that you can't lift her.
All right, let's...
Prove me wrong.
Nothing.
Okay, well, you're not gonna be able to do it.
Really?
Or you're gonna do it twice. Okay, let's try something a little bit different. All right, now you're definitely not gonna be able to do it. I told you. I told you. You won't be able to either. Earlier, they could pick her up no problem, and now she's so heavy.
So how did these muscle men lose their mojo? It's another case of brains over brawn. In this case, physics. The second time around, Karen changed her center of gravity. You can see it in this blue dot on the screen. It's the point where all her weight is concentrated. In the first attempt, she leaned into the lifters, bringing most of her weight closer to their bodies and making her easier to lift. But on the second try, she leaned forward, pulling her center of gravity 8 inches away from them. These few inches make all the difference. She effectively tripled her weight, and now she's impossible to lift. So how can you gain 220 pounds in 2 seconds? It's not about getting physical, it's about physics, and just getting a little distance.
I told you.
Get it.
I told you.
So what are we looking at? Ancient Martian canyons carved out by ocean tides billions of years ago? The majestic fjords of Norway, old as the Earth itself. Wrong on both counts, but water does run through them. Bath water. When you take the plunge in the bath or the pool, these guys and these guys wrinkle up. This, not so much. So why do our fingers wrinkle? Macaque monkeys who spend up to 2 hours a day in the water get pruny fingers and toes too, which points to its evolutionary advantage. Like your all-season radials, these wrinkles are rain treads there to channel water away and enhance your grip. The skin on your fingers has a protein called keratin. It strengthens the skin on your hands so they hold up to constant use. Keratin's the same stuff that makes your hair so strong, and it's what allows the wrinkles to form. Keratin's strong because it's woven together in a lattice structure. And that's what expands, up to 5 times in volume when water gets absorbed, which means you can do this. But back in the pool, what's doing the wrinkling isn't the water, it's your brain. That's because finger wrinkling is an autonomic response, like this, or this. Even though you're not thinking about it, your brain knows things get slippery when wet and tells your fingers and toes to wrinkle. That was really important 10,000 years ago when we needed to snatch piranhas out of the Amazon with our bare hands. So why do our fingers wrinkle today? It's no longer for survival, but it does make it a lot easier to get out of that tub.
Your brain is a battery, or a bank of about 80 billion batteries. The average neuron has a resting voltage of about 0.07 volts. Not a lot compared to a 1.5 volt AA battery, but it keeps us going with the help of something called electrolytes. They basically feed your internal electrical grid. That's why Americans spent $5.5 billion on sports drinks last year.
We need electrolytes to help keep our bodies charged, but are sports drinks the only way to replenish them? Do sports drinks really work? We've got UCLA chemistry professor Neil Garg here to test some drinks to see what packs the most electrolytes.
Have you ever heard of electrolytes?
Yeah, of course.
They're sports drinks, right?
It's in energy drinks.
Cool, not bad.
An electrolyte is a molecule that conducts electricity when it's dissolved in a liquid solution. If it can carry a current, it's an electrolyte. So do sports drinks help your body's electricity flow?
What I have here is a light bulb, and it has an anode and a cathode connected to it. To complete the circuit, all we need is some sort of chemical medium that's going to allow for electricity to flow through it, and that will be the electrolyte. The stronger the electrolyte, the brighter the bulb we're going to see. Okay, check that out, right? So your wine actually has some electrolytes in it. All right, so you can see it lights up a little bit, so it's a weak electrolyte. What this is just a glass of salt water.
Oh, wow.
Okay?
It's cool.
Right? Bright bulb, strong electrolyte. And now what we have here is sugar water. Do you want to take a guess? What do you think is going to happen?
It's going to glow just like the salt.
All right, let's see. Oh, it doesn't work. Sugar is a neutral molecule, and it's not able to carry an electrical charge.
So what does this mean for sports drinks? The bulb barely lights up. Sports drinks do contain essential electrolytes like sodium, but they're also packed with sugar, which dilutes the sodium. In fact, because of their high calorie content, sports drinks are only recommended for strenuous exercise longer than 60 minutes. So, do sports drinks really work? If you're running a marathon, go for it. But if you're just jogging around the block, they're probably not the brightest idea.